talked about for the past few weeks. We have some guest artists here. I'm going to let them introduce themselves.
The three of us are here. I'm Jim. This is Guillermo. And that's Anselmo.
Both of these guys are from Argentina.
A little bit what we're interested in doing, and the reason why we're here is that, you know, we've been teaching in rural communities in Argentina, and this is a great opportunity to do the same here.
When you show people pictures of Crosby, to pick people in Argentina, they think, well, that looks like Argentina. When you show pictures of Argentina to people in Crosby, they say, oh, well, that looks like Crosby. We have a lot of similarities. Identity, you know, who you are, who you feel you are, what you feel is the identity of this place. And you know, if there are 12, 13 people in the room, there are probably 12 to 13 different opinions, and that's absolutely fine. What we're really interested in is each of you finding out through doing video and or photography, you can choose, you can do both, it's whatever you want, is how you can best sort of represent this place, because this is going to end up as an archive. It's going to end up stored in a way.
Today we have an exercise where we will look at portraiture. Does anybody know what portraiture means?
Like sometimes the clothing people wear. Or you could even expand that to portraits don't have to be about people. They can be about animals, they can be about trees, they can be about houses, they can be about rocks. Portraits don't have to be in focus. So here's one that's just so hard and harsh and straight, like staring at you. Here's a self-portrait where the person in the picture posing as kind of the failed hunter.
So after this lecture, we're gonna do a little in-class exercise and we're gonna take portraits.
Could be creepy, could be straight up.
Something to think about, the tone that the lighting gives. So very warm, sunny day.
Riley's freezing in the winter.
Freezing.
You don't have to do it in color. You can do it black and white. You don't have to do it in black and white. You can do it in color. Okay. It can be fuzzy. It can be sharp.
Full body, half body, just the face, looking at the camera, away from the camera. I mean, you're free.
And also, you can put your camera straight up, but you can also take different angles when you're framing the photo.
Don't just go crazy taking pictures. Create the photo, look at it. That's perfect, I like it like that. And then you frame it, and then you take a picture.
That you need to have a dialogue with your subject. You have to have this vision of what it is you want to show.
Most important thing is think before shooting. Can you see her hair, like how it's glowing in the back?
That's
great, great. Looks awesome.
all set up. It's very still. But as you look at it, it sort of begins to tell a story to you, or you begin to tell a story yourself. It seems very obvious what this person is doing, but because it's frozen, it leads the viewer to start thinking about, well, what's this guy thinking? Why is he loading up this gas? What's going on? There's something mysterious here. It's on the one hand a very innocent picture, but on the other hand, it's kind of scary. With a moving image or dealing with a still image, you're dealing with images or an image that implies a story. We don't know what's over here, right? We don't know if there's a car coming or a monster, zombie, whatever.
We're going to set up in the auditorium a situation along the lines of what Jim just showed. It doesn't have to tell a story per se, like, oh, this is what's happening. It could be something weird that you can't really figure out. We have some flashlights and stuff that you can play with, and a lot of you are already dressed up. You need to stay frozen for 10 minutes. The same scene, that's what defines a tableau vivant, a living picture. And then we're gonna have a team of photographers and a team of videographers recording that same situation from different angles.
Perfect, all right, let's go.
There's somebody in the back, a video person. Could you please move a little bit? There, thank you.
Thank you.
You can vary the height. You can take it from here, from here, from here. Just try and keep it as like a movie poster scene as possible. We want her maybe a little bit lower light, just to get as much of the cuff light on the body as possible.
That's the first thing in the morning.
Action. We freeze in emotion. Put your fist up. Up in the air. Like that. There, that's it. Dramatic. You're about to bend down a little bit more. There. We want them all to fit in a photo, right? So, think about what angle would be the best. We want to have everybody's faces, instruments, all this information that will allow us to understand, or at least play with the idea of something that's going on that we want to put together.
Yeah, you're in there.
So some do verticals, some horizontals.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity. You know the roof on fire. We gon' boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, wiggle, and dance like the roof on fire. We gon' drink drinks and take shots until we fall out like the roof on fire. Now, baby, get my booty naked, take off all your clothes and light the roof on fire.
We will need to confirm an interviewing team. So what makes an interviewing team? Two things. One is empathy. So you have to develop some sort of a connection between the interviewer and the interviewee. Get really interested in that person, pay attention, and that's what's gonna bring up something probably unexpected.
So think in terms of if you're making your own interviews, you know, at home or somewhere else, that you can mix and match stuff like crazy. That's the beauty of video editing. It'd be very possible that a significant number of the images in the video would be still photographs that were perhaps taken at even another time.
We need the interviewer. We need two video cameras. Camera one will be recording sound, is also defined by being a stable camera. So remember, we were using our tripods not only to set them up on some place, but also just to hold them. So that's what camera one will do. The tripod on, and you just stay there. Camera one will look at the screen and make sure that everything's framed with the interviewer in front. Okay. Camera two is a moving camera. Camera one's right here, and I'll move around this, and I'm more flexible. Two other cameras, and they will be doing photography. And now, what are we going to be doing with photos? We'll be doing portraits, but portraits not only of the person being interviewed, but of its surrounding.
This is an abstract company, and what we do is we update or create abstracts for all the properties in Divide County, whether it's in town or farmland, and we just put together all the history from who first owned the land, who currently owns the land, and everything in between. Well, I've been here for maybe 22 years, lived in Crosby, and I guess probably like most people say, the biggest change is when the oil boom happened, and you know, we just had more people move in, and buildings started being put up and fixed up. So my husband is from Fortuna, and so his farm is here, and so we just moved closer to the farm from Williston.
What is your favorite part about Crosby?
The people in the small town, just having it not busy.
What have you learned from living in Crosby?
I grew up on a farm, and so I feel like we, you know, grow up getting a lot of experience and just the rural way of life. So it's good learning. The secret to happiness is, I don't know, staying healthy and happy, just keeping a good outlook in life, and keeping the glasses half full attitude, huh?
Would you describe the community of Crosby?
Oh, again, very nice people, close-knit. Everybody knows everybody. And it's just a very safe place. The feeling of safe, being safe.
Hi, I'm Riley.
Hi, Riley. I'm Tiffany Ryan.
Hello. What's your favorite part about Crosby?
Small town.
Really?
You enjoy that? Yep.
What keeps you here? Like, what brought you here? Why do you stay?
My husband got a job at the state 4 years ago, so that's initially why we came. Mm-hmm. And we like small towns, so.
Like, have you tried anything new here that you really like, or?
No. Well, Slingers. Slingers is good.
Slingers?
Mm-hmm.
What do they serve?
Pizza, pasta, wings.
Have you learned anything living in the area yet?
I learned about the bank shooting when the bank was down the road. You can, if you walk by, you can still see the bullet holes in the pillars. They said that somebody was up on the top of the Penny Building and was mad, and they were shooting from the roof of the Penny Building down towards where the bank used to be, which is now Henny's.
What advice would you give for someone who's never been to Crosby? Like, what would they do? Where should they go?
I don't know. It just depends, I guess, what they want to do or whatever, why they're coming here. So I guess that would just really depend. Just when people come in for like different things for their cars, whether it be windshield wipers or batteries or, you know, whatever they need, brakes. So we just get them what they need.
What do you think the secret to happiness is? Like,
good family, good friends, stable community. Be true to yourself. Basically, I know who you are.
Nice to meet you. I'm Erin.
Okay. Hello. Riley.
I'm Sierra.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
All right. Like, the station has been in business for
62
years.
Okay, cool. Who started it?
My father-in-law, Kenny Sorum.
So, y'all have been here for a really long time. Why would you say you've stayed?
Well, I've chosen.
For family.
Yeah. Just for family, I guess.
Yeah. It's a family-run business, and my kids live here, and so, yeah.
I don't know. The customers are fun some days. Some days. Not all days, but we have a lot of old men that come in for coffee hour, and they,
I didn't say that.
I don't know, I've known them since I was a little kid,
yeah.
So it's been fun to grow up.
Lots of familiar faces.
Lots of fun to grow up with them, and they mm-hmm. still come here, still talk to them every day.
Yeah.
Would you guys ever consider moving?
No, I tried that.
I didn't really like it. Probably because where I lived at the time,
yeah.
But no, not really. I don't know, it seems like I travel and go places, and I am always very happy to get back here.
Mm-hmm.
Because too many people. What advice would you guys give to the younger generations that are here?
Pick a trade. That's where you're needed.
It's where the money is.
Yeah. You want to make some money, go to a trade school.
Yeah.
Or...
Mm-hmm.
What do you guys do in your free time when you're not running the business?
I go welding in my free time. That's my side business. So I weld and play fetch with my dog. That's about it.
In my free time, while she's welding, I take care of her dog and my dog. Since I'm empty nester now, that's what I do.
She's a dog sitter.
Dog sitter.
All right. Well, it was lovely meeting y'all.
You too.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks for the
Thank
interview.
You.
How would you show Crosby to somebody that's never been in Crosby? And that can be something very open. That could be your house, that could be your neighborhood, that could be a business, a farm.
Place is a very open term. You tend to think literally often, and so we think about our house, our home, or our town, or whatever. But there also can be a place of sort of atmosphere where you might feel comfortable. On your walk today, walk home, or whatever, just look for little details, things that strike you if you put the frame of the camera, whether you're shooting the video frame or the still frame. So just look in this assignment.
Again, I'm asking you at least 5 different shots that will convey a picture of your place. And your place, again, like Jim said, could be anything. Raising the bar a little bit more, so minimum 5. But if you start counting all the shots, like what you just saw of Maria on the horse, that's like 25 different moments. And of course, feel free to do it. I mean, I just, the more ambitious, the better it'll come up. And the more work you put into it, the better it'll come up.
We just want to say it's been a tremendous privilege to work with you folks. We had no idea how things were going to go when we got here, and you folks have just been absolutely wonderful.
We've been planning this for a long time, many, many months. But it was really fun because, we got permission to photograph around the school. We're trying to make the familiar unfamiliar. So it's like, okay, let's make this be like a movie set. And then we have actors and actresses and directors of photography and creative directors, and it was all done by the kids. And that series of pictures also, it was the first time I saw them next to each other, and I thought it was brilliant, just, so spooky and mysterious and off.
There were some folks who were amazing at video editing. There were some folks who were fantastic at acting. There were some folks who were fantastic at sequencing. There were some folks who were fantastic with the camera in their hands. And just, it was really interesting watching each person, just in this little 5-day thing. It's so rewarding, as somebody who's taught for many, many years. It's so rewarding.
You have now a powerful tool, which is how you can control not only the software in your phone, but also you understand how moving images and still images work in relation to lighting and how the timing of how you edit. And
I'd like just everybody who's here that took the class to come up front. We just want to say thank you. Wonderful, and I would like you to give yourself a hand.